about myself. I'm telling you, my head will turn around like the Poltergeist movie whenever I hear girls slamming themselves. I'm fat. I look stupid. I can't stand that. And there's even a young guy, I'm not going to point around, but he even made a comment to me that he thought his body was stupid, he was never going to have the muscles and stuff like that, and I hate that. I hate defamation of character, and I hate when we do it to ourselves. Our words are so powerful, and our spirits have to be nurtured, because I don't care how perfect of a childhood you guys had, you all have stuff that was done to you, and what touches the body touches the spirit. You guys have all had evil spoken to you, spoken about you, what touches the body, my ears, touches the spirit. It has all morphed and changed and fought to keep your spirit down. Yes. The sanctification has to happen to where you dig down inside and you realize that you're not only going to guard those things that come in, but Jesus in Luke said, dig deep the foundations of your life. Dig deep. My body was made by God, and yes, I have to fight the flesh. My body is created. He likes it. He likes the way I think. He likes my original quirkiness. He likes my hyperness. He likes
that
I'm really blunt. He just needs the bluntness to be covered sometimes. But my heart, my flesh, they cry out for you, the living God, because your spirit is water to my soul. It's just a matter of disciplining the flesh as well. And what I want to say to you guys tonight, the reason I felt so impelled and pushed to come in here is because not only the ones going to IHOP, even though that is a big motivation, because I have spent time up at IHOP, and what I do know is that there is a preparation and a sanctification that you guys can start tonight. You guys can set it aside tonight. The ones who aren't going to IHOP, start making plans to go up there. You've got to get away. You've got to go do stuff like that. You've got to join into corporate. It's the way our spirits come out. You know, when you're in a room and you don't, there's no way you could know with your other senses, but you know someone's there or they're looking at you. That is the beauty of the spirit. It is an amazing thing. It permeates everything. And so what I was hoping and praying, and that, you know what, I'm just going to prophesy to you right now, is that tonight, before you guys leave this building, you guys are going to have to make the choice to open up. If you've never opened your arms up before and you've never done that, today is the day to stop caring so much about anything else besides what God has for you. Because when Pastor Anthony talked about pulling down the heavens, if he cannot tell us, if he says we can't contain it, that it would crush us, we know that God would never give us more than we can handle. We know that. I actually quoted Mother Teresa the other day, because she's actually quoted this, and I love it. And it says, God said he would never give me more than I can handle. I wish he did not trust me so much. But he won't give us more than we can handle. Whatever is on your guys' plate, whatever you guys are going after, is the equal measure for what you're going to be given. When my daughter or one of the boys runs up to me and they want to drink water, it depends on the size of their cup how much water they get. Honestly, I don't think about too much money. It's what you bring. It's the capacity. God's not going to give you more than you can handle, but he can't give you, because he will not hurt you, more than you've prepared for. And that is the importance of the sanctification, of you nurturing your own spirits, of reaching out there, setting things aside. I called my brother up one time years ago, and this just came to my mind. And I was frustrated because I had been going to church and I had been doing everything that I thought I was supposed to be doing, but I was dead, I was dry, I found myself literally going through what my menu was going to be at the Blue Top when we got out of church. And I wasn't listening to what I know is life-changing words. And so I called him up, and I just honestly probably thought I was going to get thrown. I'm like, oh, Brother Bob. And he was going to be like, oh, it's okay. You've been through a lot. But he didn't. He said, if you're not hungry, what are you full on? I was like, what? And he said, if you're not hungry, what are you full on? And then all of a sudden I pictured, you know those nights when you like go to Sonic and eat too much and then go to the movies and maybe not, maybe just leave. You're literally so full that you feel sick. It doesn't matter if you go home and the your favorite food, your steak, everything you love, the mashed potatoes, I don't even want to start talking about it. But all that's laid out. If you are full of the crap, are you going to have a hunger for that? I don't care how good it looks. I don't care what it is. There will be no drive. There will be no pushing to take what is good as in. Amber and I believe, was going to end up having more. We were in my bedroom last week. Hallelujah! Talking about this stuff. What you feed yourself on, how you can eat weight, health, and working out, and all that stuff. And I believe she has a sermon in her boiling. So, if you are not hungry, Misty, some of y'all are going up to see Sing? When you get her on, she says, hunger is the escort to the deeper things. You have to make yourself hungry. You have to nurture and discipline your spirit. You have to create and open up a lot at that point. That is when you can access Him. That is when you can reach into the heavens and you can, by right as His child, pull down the stuff. You might not get it. You might not understand it. I have loved things like Anthony said. I'm like, oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Praise the Lord. I'm like, oh, I wonder if I'm out of gas and move on. But something else will happen. My daughter was raised in going to like these different conferences and stuff. And one time we were at this, the Holy Ghost guy, we had traveled for a while. We haven't seen him in a while. He is nuts. He had yes, this guy is crazy. He's got nothing on me or anybody else. Tristan was just asleep on the stairs. And we was funny because we'd start looking over him and he'd start going, ooh, and somebody like that. She'd like twitch in her sleep. And what I absolutely believe is that in all those meetings and all that stuff, I believe beyond a shadow of a doubt that the Spirit of God was going into her and stuff was getting deposited. But I want more. I'm not a mediocre person. I just wasn't built that way. I don't like sucking at things. Am I allowed to say that out here? I don't like being bad at things. I don't like being dumb. I like to know. And when I read in the Bible the stuff that are accessible to me, when I read about these powers and these things, I want it. Preparing yourself, opening up. When we go into prayer and more worship tonight, that is your moment. Forget about the person next to you. Forget about anything else. You have to throw it off. And you open yourself up. And if you, by reaching out, draw near to Him, He will draw near to you. You will be able to make a direct connection. Brandon would not just show up at my house to fix the thing under my sink unless I reached out to him and told him of my need. And even if I just felt that I need help, Brandon would show up to help me with something at my house. Why? Because I reached out to him. I drew near to him, let him know I had a need. That is exactly what you do. In the spirit only. It is the power, the trick truck. It doesn't matter what y'all got figured out, how many anything else you know. None of it means anything. None of it means anything without the power of His Holy Spirit. He will put inside of you the answers to the dreams, the stuff that the Lord has shown you. And the places you're going, the things He's put inside of you, and your mind screams, I'm not qualified, how will I get there? Right. It's through that connection. Yeah. You guys, when I look at you guys, you have been called. The cheerleading stuff is not just some cutesy thing. It is powerful training. It is being up in front of people. It is amazing. And through that, and the Holy Spirit, He will take every gift. He will take every gift, every part of your personality, every part of your personality, stuff that other people have made fun of before. He likes it. He created it, and it was through the touch of His Holy Spirit will your answers be had. The gifts inside of you, they don't always just come popping out. That's what I have hoped for a long time. This is a vision. These people prophesied to me. Joyce Meyer said this to me. Okay, where is it? It is through His Holy Spirit that it comes in. Cody, those gifts of music and art in you, in the name of Jesus, they are going to come up. Yeah. And then, did you see what I sent you on Facebook? The prophetic college and school? Those are gifts. And even though they might lay down right now, and even though you don't see how, there's no way. I'm telling you, I am the poster child, for there is no way my life doesn't make sense. But I have accessed Him. And tonight, that's what we're going to call you guys to do, is to open up and just surrender and say, I don't get it, I don't see it. And like Kim Walker said tonight, if you don't get it and if you don't see it, you would know because it's real. And it is your choice to access it. It's here. I can feel the Spirit of God in this house right now. He has freedom for you. He has answers for you. He has strength for you. You guys are not average. You have been called, set aside, and different. It's up to you now. What you're going to access tonight is what He's going to bring you. The level that you want to go to, the level that you want to take this up to IHOP, that place is a burning inferno. My daughter and I were just up there. You get yourself covered. I don't care if you don't have to answer text tonight. I would challenge those of you going tomorrow. Don't return that text. You know what grieves Him. You just stay right here because when you leave tonight, you're going to have it. And you guard it, and you keep it, and you nourish it. And I'm telling you, when you join in up there, going apart and joining corporately, it is going to explode, and your lives are going to be changed. In the name of Jesus, lives are going to be changed. That's what I wanted to share with you guys. I know Pastor Julie can take this downtown. But I'm going to tell you guys, I do this. I was just in my bedroom doing this last night.